The start of baseball season can sometimes be a polarizing experience. People who love baseball can think of little else, want to talk about little else. They may appear to be participating in life and work as usual, but in their minds, they are on the third baseline, drinking light beer, slurping nacho cheese goo off pickled jalapeno rings while heckling the shortstop. Anybody who's not into baseball is sort of missing a whole level of American experience around opening day. Then every once in a while, there's a day of baseball so weird that even people who are not into the game find themselves paying attention. Por ejemplo, yesterday. Yesterday, the legendary superpower New York Yankees got so shellacked by Tampa Bay that they ended up putting in their first baseman, Nick Swisher, to pitch in the eighth inning. And even though he's the first baseman and he hadn't pitched since his freshman year in high school in West Virginia, Mr. Swisher was the only Yankee pitcher or otherwise to throw a scoreless inning as the team got beat 15-5. Fans of New York's other team, the Mets, live to revel in Yankee suffering. Last night, the Mets opened their new stadium, Citi Field, which went great. Till the game started. The first batter in the first inning in the first game in the history of Citi Field, Jody Garrett, hit a home run for San Diego against the Mets. And downhill from there. With everything tied up in the sixth inning, Mets pitcher Pedro Feliciano balked. He balked, he twitched, and thus balked in the run that lost the game for New York on opening night at their new stadium. Also, there was a cat loose on the field who ran over near home plate right in front of New York Governor David Paterson. Not to be upstaged, New York City's Mayor Mike Bloomberg grabbed a baseball after a wild pitch in the ninth. In Chicago, things were just as weird yesterday, but also totally awful and disgusting. A dead goat found hanging from a rope on a statue outside Wrigley Field. A similar thing happened at the same spot in 2007, which is the image you see there. Needing a little help with my Curse of the Billy Goat lore and needing a little perspective on night one at Citi Field and how weird things get in baseball? We are joined now by Mr. Keith Olbermann, host of Countdown here on MSNBC. You can check out Keith's baseball blog titled Baseball Nerd at keitholbermann.mlblogs.com. Keith, many thanks for making it a late night.
I had to be here anyway for the 10 o'clock show.
Oh, very good. Sure. There's that.
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Jody Garrett, by the way, Countdown and Rachel Maddow show viewer Jody Garrett.
Oh, really?
That and that's the first time anybody has ever christened a stadium with a home run. First batter in a stadium hits a home run. Never happened before, and there have been a lot of stadiums in baseball history.
Hello, Mr. Garrett. Congratulations to you. Very exciting. Please, will you explain the Curse of the Billy Goat thing?
I'm not sure about that. The Curse of the Billy Goat supposedly dates to 1945, the last time the Chicago Cubs were in the World Series, and a guy who'd been going to games with his goat all season long was denied. He couldn't bring the goat in during the World Series.
Okay.
And he promised it was some sort of curse on the Cubs that they'd never win. I never heard this story until the 80s, and I was a baseball historian when I was a kid. I think they made it up in the 80s. So anyway, the premise of it is that there's some sort of Billy Goat tavern curse put on the Cubs. They'll never win until somehow they exercise this. That they haven't won has been more the result of bad trades than it has been bad goats. And I guess that's some sort of ritual. Either that or you have Satan worshippers who work for the Cubs, which is also a possibility.
And which also might have some explanatory value on the World Series thing, maybe?
Yeah, also not playing in the World Series very often will keep you from winning the World Series more than anything else.
There is so much superstition in baseball. Yes. I have to ask you if there's now going to be some complicated new superstition about the cat at Citi Field on opening night.
It's an old superstition, actually. In 1969, 40 years ago, when the Chicago Cubs were in, those same Chicago Cubs were in first place, and the New York Mets had never not finished last, the Mets were gaining on the Chicago Cubs. And in a critical Cubs-Mets game at Shea Stadium, a black cat ran in front of the Cubs dugout, stopped, hissed at the Cubs, and moved along. And that was supposedly, it turned out, of course, later on we find out the cat was owned by one of the trainers and one of the groundskeepers at Shea Stadium. And the whole thing was, there it is.
There's the aforementioned black cat.
And the whole thing was kind of set up, at least by Mets fans, if not employees. So it was not, it's not as random as it appeared, but it evoked that thing once again. On the other hand, it had nothing to do with Governor Paterson. He did not try to leap into the, and all the bad jokes that ensued from that. But I mean, the poor cat comes out of nowhere. Next to Citi Field is a whole bunch of chop shops, car lots, and all winter long they had animals appearing out of nowhere in the construction site at Citi Field. So this is not as weird as it sounds.
But the cat wanted to get out of the field and couldn't.
Couldn't because of the screen. It could not get through the screen wild pitch that Bloomberg came up with somehow got through the screen.
But the cat hit the screen.
Yeah, the cat could not get through the screen, and Governor Patterson would have not known what hit him, as it were.
Yeah, there's that bad joke.
And it,
how does a ball...
Sounded like a cat.
How does a...
I'm getting a job on Saturday Night Live now. Won't I have one more? I apologize.
Balk is one of those baseball terms that I am very familiar with as an analogy.
Yeah.
I'm not familiar at all with it as an actual phenomenon in baseball.
It is actually much simpler than it sounds. It is any motion that the pitcher makes to deliberately deceive a base runner.
Okay.
In other words, to make him think he's throwing to the plate when he's actually throwing to first base to check on the base runner, or vice versa. So when Pedro Feliciano of the Mets was in the set position, he made a slight motion like that, which is legally interpreted within baseball rules as a balk. There was a runner at third base at the time, and he is then entitled to advance one base. It happened to decide the first game in the Mets history at this ballpark. Talk about opening night jitters, that's the literal definition of it.
Could you, you were there, could you discern his intent?
Intent has nothing to do with it.
Ah.
It is if you do it, it is either if it is intended to deceive or serves to deceive, even if it's an accident.
Right.
And a pitcher who's concentrating on the sign from his catcher, the signals about which pitch to throw, may at some point lose his focus, lose his concentration, and suddenly think, forget about the runner at first base, the runner at third base, and make some sort of motion or just twitches. But it was just sort of decisive last night.
Last question.
Yeah.
Can we do this all the time?
To kind of talk about baseball every time? Sure, could we do it earlier in the show?
Yes, we could.
Could you mind doing it at, say, at 9:01 rather than 9:45?
That would be absolutely fair.
Okay, fine.
Keith, thank you very much. I understand that you've got Scott McClellan tonight, is that right?
Scott McClellan on the Bush reunion that he's not going to. It's wonderful to talk to him because it's like he's reborn in that religious sense.
He's free.
He's free, and as I said to him, it's always cathartic to talk to him.
Keith Olbermann, you should check out Keith's new blog on baseball, which is titled Baseball Nerd.
You bet it is.
You can find it at keitholbermann.mlblogs.com. It has lots of really good pictures.
I took those pictures myself.
It's also a very cute picture of you.
Yeah, I didn't take that
picture. Super excited to be there.
It's my New York Cubans uniform.
Keith, thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Countdown is up next, of course. But first on this show, a Blagojevich reality show.
First.
For real? For real? Really?